Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
It is Thursday, the 16th day of December, 2010. We've got the radio broadcast jam-packed with guests tomorrow. We're only going to get one guest on towards the end of the broadcast today, but I'll announce that later. We're going to have open phones today, and I will take your questions, your comments, any news items that you want to raise. We're going to have open phones throughout the full 3 hours, interspersed with a lot of really important news. But any subject you want to raise, any point you want to make, I want to hear from you. I'm going to attempt to try to move quickly through your calls, but also I need your calls to be brief and focused. And I need to be brief and focused as well if we're going to get to a lot of your phone calls. But I love the different issues and points and angles that listeners bring up when we take open line a day of phone calls. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. We'll get you up and on the air. Well, I have a lot of interesting news here in front of me. Remember, I've been predicting false flag stage terror attacks ahead of the election and then intensifying from there on out. The government likes to go out and find mindless patsies that they try to provocateur with fake bombs into attacking. That way, they don't have to stage the events and then get caught. But they love to make you focus on Homeland Security as the center of the family, as the center of the culture, as basically a little baby Jesus in the creche, there with Mary and Joseph and the three wise men. Just like at Walmart, when you're checking out, they're at the market, they have big droning, well, now 9,000 different stores, not just the 800-plus Walmarts are announcing. And it'll be 20,000, then 50,000, and then just everywhere. Government droning, giving you orders. It's the boss. It's the master. They make the sunshine. They make the grass grow. So they want to make sure during the Christmas holiday that you learn to worship naked body scanners, you learn to worship black uniforms, you learn to worship threat fusion centers that spy on you, you learn to worship the foreign banks raping you, or the dangerous, scary men with turbans will get you. And they're hiding under every desk, in every closet, under every bed, in every cupboard, in every attic, in every basement, in every culvert out in the park that kids are scared of. There's not trolls now in there. There's Alcyaidas, and they're going to get you. Got a better chance, again, of dying from being struck by lightning or when you're swimming or from a bee sting, but doesn't matter. It's scary. Doesn't matter if 5 to 12, depends on the year, between 5 and 12 people die from shark attacks. Everybody's scared when they're swimming in the ocean. It's the same thing. It's not real. It's not rational. But, oh, my gosh, I mean, these men are wearing turbans. This is scary. We've got to get rid of our free country. We've got to let the banks rob us because they want to help us. Or Al-Qaeda will get us. I mean, it's that simple. And here they are. Iraq. Al-Qaeda planning holiday attacks in the West. That's the headline here out of CBS News. Be afraid. Be very afraid. I know I certainly am. I'm just glad Goldman Sachs is stealing all the money. That'll save us. Here's a mail online. Christmas chaos. Al-Qaeda. Mm-hmm. Is planning suicide attacks across Europe and the U.S. war insurgents. And don't worry, though, YouTube allows users to flag content as terror promotion. So now somebody can go say your video is violent or not appropriate. It could be two adults videotaping themselves playing Candyland or Tiddlywinks. And if someone says it's frightening to them, it's taken off YouTube. Oh, it's frightening. Oh. Well, now, if someone says it's promoting terror, it's gone. So this is the new communist America, the new Soviet, where your neighbor has said that you are evil. The East German Stasi will not take you away. And collective punishment when Al-Qaeda blows something up. We all have to have the government put their hands down our pants. It's all coming up. Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv. Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones, and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued legislation threatening the sale of nano-silver products, you can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs Generator. Very easy to follow, step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. That's www.silverlungs.com. A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have wide open phones today. And then in the last 30 minutes of the third hour, we're going to have a guest on from a local activist group that has gone to the city council, gone to the different boards, and got the council subgroups to vote and say that Austin doesn't want naked body scanners in the airport. And that's a tag. Texans for Accountable Government doing a great job. But the larger issue here is we have this happening in Florida, Colorado, and a whole bunch of other states. Major towns and cities have had their district attorneys, their county attorneys come out and say, if you stick your hands down people's pants, you're going to go to prison. Hands down the pants is a felony, and they do that. Hands through the pants squeezing, that is a misdemeanor. And we've had some of those county and city attorneys on. And here's the big news. And I'm going to cover this again coming up in the third hour. The big news here is that Aaron Dykes and Rob Dew flew back from interviewing Charlotte Iserby. And by the way, she showed them secret Skull and Bones books of her father and grandfather. This is the stuff Anthony Sutton used, his secret source. They actually went up there and got to get a look at it and videotape it, and that's going to be up on PrisonPlanet.tv first of the year with a special report, probably be 2 hours long. Oh, yeah. Charlotte Isby just wasn't the head of policy Department of Education. She's the person that blew Skull and Bones wide open more than 20 years ago. But continuing with this information, I'm already digressing. They flew back through Boston Logan, which is always been the test airport, the most draconian. I mean, they had naked body scanners in there years ago. They had passive MRI brain scanners that I saw 8 years ago being tested. It's the main beta testing center. Other airports are to a certain extent, like LAX, JFK, and others. But this is the one where they really, really have been putting the screws in since day one. And Aaron and them flew through. They weren't using the body scanners. This was just on Wednesday they flew back. They interviewed her on Monday, but they flew back Tuesday. The point is, they just flew back earlier this week, and they were not doing pat-downs, they were not using body scanners, and we're getting more and more reports that they're not using them at most airports, and they're not sticking hands down pants, they're not ripping colostomy bags off the sides of people, they're not making women take out their artificial breast if they've lost their breast through mastectomies from breast cancer or other injuries or problems. They've really backed off because, A, they know that this is causing a general revolt, but B, and probably more important, all over the country, city councils, state legislatures, county attorneys, city attorneys, state police are saying, we're going to arrest you. You're not above the law. A sworn peace officer can't stick their hands down somebody's pants unless it's an emergency or unless it is warrant situation. And they go on and say, don't give us this garbage that you've bought your ticket, so you've agreed. You can't buy a ticket and go to a topless bar and have one of the topless dancers stick their hand down your pants just because it's consensual. What you're doing is illegal. Don't do it anymore. You can't treat everyone as if they're guilty until proven innocent to keep you safe from the boogeyman. You can't kill a free society and destroy everyone's rights in the name of safety. It doesn't work. It's a fraud. And it won't keep you safe. As Benjamin Franklin said, those that will give up liberty for so-called security will get none of it. In fact, there's several variants of the quote. He said, those that give up liberty for security will get neither. Liberty or security. And then he had a longer quote where he said, and they don't deserve it. But you can pull up those famous quotes if you'd like to see them in their full context. But that's common sense that we're dealing with here. And so it's very exciting to see this happening. Ahead of having our guest on, I want to play the local news piece to analyze it and critique it. Because the local news shows the city a regulation board that did vote 5-0 against the naked body scanners. But then the news says, well, that's only ceremonial because the TSA makes the final decision. The TSA put into place after 9/11, the TSA gropers that were put into place by the transportation arm of Homeland Security. That agency was previously there, but they started the basic airport takeover at that point. That's all voluntary. The airports don't have to have them there. And it's the city of Austin that paid for the bonds for that stinking international airport. I paid for it. And so we elect our city council. And this is our town. This is not run by the feds. See, this is a 10th Amendment issue that goes right down to the city, the county, the state. I mean, the federal government is now saying they want to have TSA and they're beta testing it on every major highway, on street corners, at bus stations, at train stations, at malls. They're already putting TSA-controlled announcements through Homeland Security in, first it was 800-plus Walmarts, now it's 9,000 retail centers. In the space of 2 weeks, it's gone from 800-plus to 9,000-plus in Homeland Security press releases. Just telescreens everywhere saying, watch your neighbor. This isn't freedom. Okay? I mean, it's just common sense. I know you know that. But the exciting news is all over the country, from Austin, Texas to Orlando, Florida, people are saying no. And I was watching this YouTube video. It's up on the Alex Jones channel on YouTube. Paul Watson's written an article about it, but he actually posted the local news station's video.